Shout Jericho destroying, hallelujah. If you know you are having the largest breakthrough in this meeting, shout the loudest, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Sing this song loud and clear. In Jesus' name, every knee shall bow. In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
In Jesus' name,
every knee shall bow.
Amen. I have found Jesus. Amen. Able to do all things, hallelujah.
Amen. I have found Jesus,
hallelujah.
Amen. He is able to do all things,
hallelujah.
Amen. I have found Jesus,
hallelujah.
Amen. He is able to do all things,
hallelujah.
Amen. I have found Jesus,
hallelujah.
Able to do all things.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I have found Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He is able to do all things.
My fears, let me hide in you.
Let me hide in you.
In you there is power, the rock that never fails.
Let me hide in you. Let me hide in you. In you there is power,
oh, that rock that never fails.
Let me hide in you.
Yes.
Let me hide in you.
Yes.
In you there is power,
oh, that rock that never fails.
Let me hide in you. Let me hide in you. In you there is power,
oh, that rock that never fails.
Let me hide in you. Let me hide in you. In you there is power.
We are marching forward, hallelujah.
Amen. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Amen.
Oh, we are marching forward,
hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Amen.
Oh, we are marching forward,
hallelujah. Yes. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Amen.
Oh, we are marching forward,
hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Amen.
Oh yes, in a carnage.
He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara.
Oh yes, in a carnage.
He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara.
Oh yes, in a carnage.
He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara.
Oh yes, in a carnage.
He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara. He gave the nobara.
Oh sagara, toda biti Jesu.
Oh sagara, toda biti Baba.
Oh sagara.
Baba,
ah.
Go so look on. He can never fail. Jesus is same forever.
Hallelujah.
He can never fail. Jesus is same forever.
Hallelujah.
He can never fail. Jesus is same forever.
Father, we thank you once again for tonight. And we thank you for your grace, your power. We thank you, Lord, for this program. We thank you for your grace and your power. We thank you for the mightiness of the name of the Lord. We thank you for your name, which is above all names. Father, I'm praying for all who are gathered here now, that any challenge that any of them may be having, let those challenges become testimonies in the name of Jesus. Let those challenges become testimonies in the name of Jesus. Every call of darkness against anyone gathered here, let the call be paralyzed. Let the call of the enemy expire. Let the power of the enemy expire. Let the yoke of the enemy be broken. Any plantation of darkness in any life, let the plantation be uprooted. 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 In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, anything the enemy has stolen from anyone, repossess your possession in the name of Jesus. Repossess your possession in the name of Jesus. Repossess your possession in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Can you raise your voice and shout this tenfold? Say, where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Shout it 10 times. Let's go. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Arise and enlarge my coast. Father, I'm praying for all who have said these prayers. By the power that establishes the heavens and the earth, by the power that disgraced Goliath, that is by the power that put to shame the power of Pharaoh and Herod, receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Receive enlargement of coast in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We're looking at this short message before we begin to pray. It is called Converting Your Mistakes into Miracles. Converting your mistakes into miracles. In Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16. Proverbs 24, verse 16. For a just man falleth 7 times and riseth up again. But the weak wicked shall fall into mischief. A just man falleth seven times and riseth up again. It doesn't stay down there. It gets up again. But the wicked shall fall into mischief. In Psalm 37 now, from verse 23. Psalm 37, verse 23. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighted in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholded him with his hand. Listen carefully, beloved. No human being can lay claim to be 100% perfect all the time. I'll say that again. No human being can lay claim to being 100% perfect all the time. The only person who is perfect is our Father in heaven. The day you begin to make claims that you are perfect, you have enrolled in the school of failure. So, beloved, mistakes are part of one's daily life. And people do make mistakes. Mistakes can be made on your job. Mistakes can be made on your choice of friends. Mistakes can be made through your financial decisions. Mistakes can be made in the course of your duties. I remember a friend of mine, the first time he had to go and do some burial. He was so nervous. He was conducting his first burial. He was so nervous. He was holding his Bible. His hands were shaking so badly. The Bible fell into the grave. It was very embarrassing. It was a mistake. But from that day, he never made that kind of mistake again. Though some mistakes can be devastating, but majorly mistakes can be converted into your good. Past failure can become future success. There are many mistakes that Christians, believers, they make. Number one, we make mistakes from negligence. Such mistakes generally happen as a result of laziness, oversight, indiscipline, inconsistency. Eli, the priest Eli, was a negligent father. Two, there could be mistakes from foolish curiosity. Foolish curiosity. This affects mostly the young. Oh, come on, don't be so old-fashioned. Come on, try, it won't harm you. This is how smoking, drug addiction, fornication, perversion, this early starts. When they start, they felt they could control it, but it's now controlling them. Three, there are mistakes from fear of being in a hurry. Many make terrible decisions because of panic and fear. Many make terrible decisions because they're in a hurry. They want to get money in a hurry. They want everything in a hurry, 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 hurry. They want a God of the microwave. So they make mistakes. Number four, there are ignorant mistakes. For example, Moses killing the Egyptian was an ignorant mistake. The person may have the right motive and good intention, but is now using the wrong strategy. So the earlier we understand all these things, the better for us. The earlier you understand some things I'm going to say now, the better for you. For you, if you want to correct mistakes, it is not necessary to understand everything. It is not necessary for you to understand everything. Get that into your system. It is not necessary for you to have your way all the time. Get that too into your system. It is not necessary for you to be as gifted or as talented as somebody is. It's not necessary. You don't have to be competing with people. It is not necessary for you to be greatly appreciated and praised like the other person. It is not necessary for you to be as wise or as prosperous as somebody else. You can recover from all the mistakes in life and get them converted to miracles. You say, how do I do that? How do I convert my mistakes to miracles? Number one, do not pamper your mistakes. Don't pamper it. Recognize it. Confess it to God. Do not justify your mistakes. Confess the mistakes to others who were badly affected. Do not be too proud to do this. Because if you are too proud to do this, you will not be able to convert your miracles, your mistakes to miracles. So step one, do not pamper your mistakes. Many are looking for those who will pamper them. Pamper them. This is why God had to remove Joseph from under his father, Jacob. Because Jacob loved him too much. Was spoiling him. Was sewing clothes for him. And when Joseph began to talk what he should not talk to his brethren, the father loved him so much and didn't want to really castigate him too much. If Joseph had remained under Jacob, he would have been a spoiled child. He would not have been able to do anything with his life. The father will keep pampering him. Pampering him. Pampering him. Some are looking for those who will pamper them. And they are not happy when they see somebody lashing out at them or correcting them. The people they like is also pamper their errors, pamper their mistakes, and just say, just go on, just go on, just go on. Just go on. People like that, they are killers when they pamper your mistakes. Pamper your mistakes instead of addressing the error and say, this is wrong. I met a man the other time and I told him that you were a wicked man. He was a house master in his school. And one day he saw two girls fighting in school. Serious fight. He separated the quarrel. Took them to the office and asked them, what was the matter? Why are you fighting yourself? the two girls were fighting themselves because both of them were befriending one teacher, the vice principal of the school. Two girls. So this, they were fighting. So this husband said, why are you fighting? Hey, he wants to take my boyfriend. So he wants to take my boyfriend. Say, ah, you in this school, you having boyfriend? This is a girls' school. Had no boys. My boyfriend is vice principal. Second one to say, my boyfriend is vice principal. When the man had vice principal, I said, okay. You know what you're going to do? Let me teach you wisdom. You go and see Monday to Wednesday. You Thursday to Sunday. So don't fight again. Both of you just be sharing him. He said that is what he told the guys. I said, but sir, why did you do that? I said, I don't want to lose my job. I said, you're a wicked man. You want to pamper them into destruction. So the first key, do not pamper your mistakes. The second key, recognize the gateway of your past mistakes. Carefully evaluate the past to avoid similar mistakes. Look back to where you've made the wrong move. Look back to see the kind of things you did you're not supposed to do. Do not repeat the mistakes. Evaluate the past mistakes and do not repeat them. Three. Learn your lessons. In Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise. But a companion of fools shall be destroyed. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise. But a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Learn your lesson. In Psalm 119, verse 71. Psalm 119, verse 71. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. The prodigal son eventually came to himself. He learned his lessons. God can sometimes allow things to happen to us so that we can learn our lessons. Yours could be anger, impatience, excessive talking, prayerlessness, looseness. The question is, have you learned a lesson? Learn your lesson. The school of life will keep repeating your lessons to you until you've learned that those lessons will make you to be repeating the class until you learned your lessons. Point number four, make up your mind to stop putting ammunition in the hands of your enemies. Stop harming your enemies to fight you. Stop feeding your enemies hard to give you a hard battle. Stop talking to everyone about your mistakes, about your problems. You may be supplying information to the enemy. Five, make restitution where necessary. Make restitution where necessary. True repentance must always include restitution. You cannot say you want to completely erase past mistakes when you refuse to make restitution. Exodus chapter 22. Exodus 22 verse 1. Exodus 22:1. If a man shall steal an ox or a sheep and kill it or sell it, he shall restore 5 oxen for an ox and 4 sheep for a sheep. Taking something that does not belong to you, for you to be completely free, you must do restitution. And in Luke chapter 19 verse 8, Luke 19:8, we're talking about making restitution where necessary. And Zacchaeus stood. Luke 19:8. And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, "Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man, by false accusation, I restore him fourfold." So stolen items, cleverly concealed sins, stealing by style will not allow you to convert your mistakes to miracles. A brother had the message of restitution, was touched to his heart. He remembered he was working for his uncle many years ago. And was stealing the man's money. Now he has left the man. He's on his own. Now he had the message of restitution. So he came to me and said, "Jill, I want to go and make restitution." I said, "Okay. Do you know how much you have stolen?" Sir, it's a lot of money, sir. Said, "If I calculate, maybe it will be up to 250,000. 250,000 naira. We're talking about many, many years ago. I said, "Okay, how much of that money do you have?" "Sir, I don't have anything." "Then don't go until you get us something." I said, "But the burden is hot in my heart. I must go, I must go." So he didn't listen to me. So he bought bread. Brought orange. And went. And went to the house of your uncle. And he greeted the man. The man greeted him and said, "You're welcome. Long time." I said, "Uncle, I'm here for a different reason. Take this bread, take this orange." Uncle said, "Thank you so much." He said, "But why are you here?" And he said, "Well, I was working for you years back. I was stealing the money." I said, "Okay, so what? So you were stealing my money. So what did you have? You brought the money back?" "So no, I just want you to forgive me." The man took the bread and the orange and used it to flog his head and chase him back to the car park. They came back to see me. I said, well, you see yourself? You have to do a restitution. That's why you don't repeat past mistakes. Point number six. Those who want to convert their mistakes to miracles, you must be a source of blessing to others. Go out of your way to be a blessing to others. Think about it. Sit yourself down and talk to yourself. What can I do to help others? What can I do to help another person to succeed? Those who were blessed in scripture were those who originally went out of their ways to be a blessing to others. Elijah told the widow of Sarephath, what do you have in your house? Say, a little jar of oil and some milk. So go and bring it for me. The woman said, man of God, that's the last thing we have for me and my child to eat it and die. Nevertheless, you are a prophet of God, you are asking for it. So go and bring it. And immediately that woman said that, she opened uncommon doors of breakthrough to her own life. And the man said, that jar of oil shall not dry. The meal shall not be spent until the famine clears away from the land. If she had said no, I can't give anything. What will I eat? It is that hunger that will have killed her. Go out of your way to be a blessing to others. Seven. Count your blessings and always glorify the Lord. Count your blessings and glorify the Lord. That takes us to that our popular song. When upon life's billows you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking that all is lost, say, count your many blessings, count them one by one, and you will be surprised what the Lord has done. Say, count your blessings, count them one by one. Count your blessings. See what the Lord has done. You'll be surprised what He has done in your life. God is a God who doesn't want us to forget His benefits. He wants us to remember His blessings. So bless the Lord, O my soul. So forget not all His benefits. Eight. Never give up. Don't give up. In Psalm 145, verse 14, Psalm 145, verse 14, the Lord upholdeth all that that fall, and raised up all those that be bowed down. Psalm 145, verse 14. Never give up. And finally, number nine, arrest the spirit of error. Error is sometimes a spirit. Arrest that spirit. Arrest the spirit. So that you will be able to convert all those mistakes to miracles. In case you have listened to me now, you are not born again, you have not surrendered your life to Jesus, you have a great opportunity to do so by closing your eyes, raising up your right hand, and say what I'm going to say after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from now, I say bye-bye to the devil. enter into the kingdom of light. In Jesus' name. Amen. You say that short prayer with me. The ushers will meet with you, with the counselors. Or you can contact us using our number on the screen. Thank you, Jesus. Right there where you are, with your eyes closed, I'd like you to see us now. And the Lord will meet you at the point of your needs as you participate in the prayers. Thank you, Jesus. With your right hand, begin to clear the realm over your head. Do it prophetically. Clear the realm from over your head. Thank you, Jesus. Say, my heaven, open by fire. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and declare, open heaven upon your life. Declare, open heavens upon your life. Ba se ke orun lori re ko si. Open by fire. Si ni pa ino. In Jesus' name we pray. Loruko Jesu la gbadura. I decree an immediate miracle upon my life. Mo pa ise ise iyanu lese kese sori aye mi. I decree. Mo pa ise an immediate miracle. Ise iyanu lese kese sori aye mi. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and decree. He said decree. Ase ni. Thank you, Jesus. Osheun Jesu. Thank you, Jesus. Osheun Jesu. In Jesus' name we pray. Loruko Jesu la gbadura. Any evil thing. Ohun buburu yohu. Hiding in my life. Can I hear you shouting this? Come to the surface now. What's it about you? In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and decree that I want you. Command you to come to the surface. What's it about you? Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Loruko Jesu la gbadura. By the thunder of your power. Ni pa agbara re. My Father. Baba mi. Move upon my life. Can you shout his love? Your voice is not loud enough. In the name of Jesus. Basati alikatendekea. Riboko posa duasa. I told you. Go with me. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu la gbadura.
Anointing to move me forward.
Iforoyan lati mu mi tesiwaju.
Manifest in my life.
Faraon
ninu. In the name of Jesus.
Loruko Jesu.
Yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu.
Say powers.
Abdara.
Assigned to kill by Israel.
He won all that to buy Israel.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Ribo sependa kaya boshenta. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu.
Oh God, our Lord.
Olorun dide.
Give me power to excel. In the name of Jesus, power to excel. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu la gbadura.
Say evil dedication.
Infinity buburu.
Speaking against my destiny. Die by the blood of Jesus.
Who? By Jesus.
Evil dedication. Speaking against my destiny. Die by the blood of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth, open your mouth. This is why Jesus brought you here. We are here for a purpose. We are not here to joke. Break, 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 break. Aha! It's happening now.
Oh, this shall have you.
Yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu.
Say, my Father.
Baba mi.
I need help. poli katasanda. Yes.
Benny.
Yes.
Benny.
Aha.
Benny.
Aha.
Benny.
Receive help. 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 Boka pola katala kaya boshanta. Riba sapanda kancha. Jesus.
Then we pray. Something is about to happen now. Lay your hands on your stomach and shout this loud. Evil food.
Evil food.
That I have eaten through polygamous witchcraft. Can you shout out loud? Catch fire! In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus' name we pray.
Loruko Jesu la gbadura.
Shout this loud and clear.
Ki gbe le lohun rara.
Dreams of failure.
Dreams of failure.
Alaikuna.
I am not your candidate.
Emi o si fun yin.
Backfire.
Abaja lo bi e ti wa.
In the name of Jesus.
Loruko Jesu.
Dreams of failure. Today is today. You must not negotiate.
Oh God, do not do that.
This is not a day to negotiate.
Aha.
In Jesus' name we pray. If you don't like this next prayer, please keep quiet.
Oh, but fairna adura to kan ipa no mo.
Every mockery of the enemy.
Gbogbo ipegan latodo ota
pretending to love me.
To se bi pe o fairna mi.
Can you shout this loud?
E ki gbere lo rara.
Your voice is not loud enough.
Oh, you na so ke to.
Jesus. Kill the mockery.
Pa, if I go.
Oh yes. Oh yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus, then we pray.
Loruko Jesus. Lagbadura.
Every evil bird.
Gbogbo eye buburu.
Crying against the glory of my star.
Tonke lodi si ogo irawo mi.
Can I hear you saying this loud?
Ego soke kin gbo yin.
Is that the loudest you can shout it?
Se le go soke ju ba yen lo mi.
Jesus. Oh yes.
Ben.
Kill the birds.
Wow, where you know?
Somebody's breaking through. Somebody's breaking through. Continue, continue, continue.
T'assois-tu, t'assois-tu, t'assois-tu.
Jesus, then we pray.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you,
Jesus.
Before we pray on the manna water, bring out your tithes and offering for this meeting. Father, we thank you for the tithes and the offering. A good measure, praise, and falling over. Let it be our Lord in the name of Jesus. Let your power and anointing overshadow our lives.
In
Jesus' name we pray. Your manna water now, and let your amen roar like fire and like thunder. Thank you, Jesus. I'm decreeing the life of somebody. If anybody has used any padlock against your career, against your progress, against your husband, against your children, against your business, I break the padlock in the name of Jesus. Let it be broken. 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 In the name of Jesus. We thank you for this manna water. We brought it here according to your commandment. Let every particle of the water presented now become the blood of Jesus. Let every particle of this water become the fire of the God of Elijah. Let his water burn to ashes every cage of darkness. Let his water burn to ashes every infirmity. Let his water dissolve every bad luck. Let his water become the water of conception, the water of glory, the water of fire, the water of breakthrough, the water of progress, the water of resurrection. In the name
Jesus.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
The Lord blesses you from Zion. And make his face to shine upon you. And be gracious unto you. Father, all the prayer requests are answered them by fire. As your people go away from here, let them experience the touch of Jehovah. The God of the suddenly. The God of mysterious surprises. Shall answer his name in your life in the name of Jesus. Every power that wants you to be disgraced shall be disgraced. Any power that wants you to be put to shame shall be put to shame. To you, Father, be the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Let us share the grace in fellowship.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.